If he hit it over the wall, it would have just been another accomplishment. What made it different was he pointed at the wall. Well, that's what I was out to do then. And it was risky. Billy Mitchell, video game player of the century. It's rather simple. If you want to get a perfect game, you walk up, you put your quarter in, you press start, you eat every dot, you eat every prize, every energizer, and on every energizer, you got to get all four guys every time. If you miss a guy, you're done. If you miss a prize, you're done. You miss anything, you're done. You die one time, you're done.
Just to give you an idea, watch how fast they turn back. And you gotta get all four.
256 boards over many, many hours, never dying once, never missing a point. I had all kinds of people, oh, you can't do it. Oh, no one's ever done that. There's no way you can do that. Bet you can't. I'd say don't bet your life.
Sorry, I'm just showing off here.
Bill Mitchell is the Jerry Rice or the Michael Jordan of all the video game players.
Man, he's phenomenal.
Very loud, very outspoken, very confrontational.
And one of the lines he would always say to me is, Steve, when I met you, I was but the learner. But now, I am the master.
Mitchell walks into an arcade, you know, everything stops. There's electricity around Billy Mitchell. Everybody wants to crowd around him. Everybody wants to see him.
You know, everything about him is perfect. You know, Billy is just that person, you know, he wants to represent.
If you could hack into the machine and program it to play itself, you couldn't even program it that well.
There's a glamour to Billy. There's a specialness to Billy. He was the first. He was the first great, great player.
The fact of the matter is, Bill is the best classic arcade gamer of our era.
It's actually carved a part of my personality that benefits me every day. I mean, a burning passion never to settle for what I have. In my business, in my family, that's what competitive gaming has done for me.
He's a winner. Billy Mitchell is absolutely a winner.
It's sort of like being in a maze. But everything you see is actually sauce. The all-around most seasoned person in the hot sauce chicken wing industry, yeah, for sure, me. There's the production end of it. There's the preparation. When there's the sales end of it, there's not somebody who encompasses all of those areas like me that I've ever met.
He sells his hot sauce, he sells himself.
Because he's so charming and such a good ambassador for all gaming because he's positive. There's no reason, in my opinion, why Billy Mitchell couldn't end up on a Wheaties box someday.
The video arcade classic has finally been conquered. On July 4th at a New Hampshire arcade, 34-year-old Billy Mitchell became the first person to master Pac-Man by recording the first ever perfect game.
Mr. Nakamura, who's the father of Pac-Man, he presented me with an award for Pac-Man for having done the world's first perfect game. So sometimes when I'm with someone, oh, you think you know more about the games than the people who made them? Yeah, they told me I do.
It's a very interesting experience to see the whole video game hobby become so big that they're now stars like building.
I'd be lying to you if I told you it wasn't fun. I'd be lying to you if I told you I didn't enjoy it.
Look at him. He sticks out like a sore thumb. He's got, what is this? What do they call that? That hairdo.
Business up front, party in the back.
He has this hairdo like a country western singer. What do they call those?
Short on top and long in back.
That's a mullet.
A mullet?
That's called a mullet.
The mullet.
Mullets rock.
So he's very, very noticeable.
Of course I was famous.
Through every board, getting every dot, every energizer, every ghost that's applicable to reach to the final 256 screen without dying? That's impressive in its own right.
The success of this was not just because someone got a perfect Pac-Man score, but because Billy Mitchell got a perfect Pac-Man score.
The first time Chris and I met, I was playing Miss Pac-Man, and he was looking over my shoulder. I finished five boards. He says, wow. He sat down next to me, he put a quarter in, and bang, he hit 77-6 on the first shot. It's in your DNA. You have it or you don't. He is
every reason why I am the video game champion. Everything I've done, I owe to him. If I hadn't met him, if we hadn't pushed each other, I would not have achieved what I've achieved. Similar to Mark McGwire and Sammy Sosa in the Home Run Derby. This pattern is called Tunnel Terror. It's called that because it's considered the safest pattern. It's 56 seconds long, and 28 of the 56 seconds, the three priority monsters are in the tunnel. As long as they're in the tunnel, they can't do you any harm. That's exactly one half of the maze. They get put in the tunnel here, and they just continually get pushed back and forth. The only reason why they're let out of the tunnel for any period of time is when we have to get the key in the center of the screen. The key in the center of the screen we need simply because we need the points. Otherwise, we just keep them locked in the tunnel. So we got the key, and now we're going to send them back in the tunnel. Again, they spend their life in the tunnel.
No!
Okay, watch right here. Don't blink, you'll miss it.
What? How is that even possible?
What do you mean how? Because I'm Billy Mitchell.
Yes!
Video games are meant to be played in a competitive environment, under pressure, organized, where you have to perform literally on demand. And when you do that, you have far more credibility than someone who says, oh, I did that last week. No matter how good you play tennis, no matter how good you play golf, if you don't play when you have to play, if you don't play when the pressure's on, you're really not good enough. When you want to put a score up and you want to have a title of world champion, you're competing against everybody in the world. You want a title for your own living room? Man, I'll send you that title. Your own arcade? Man, I'll sign it and I'll make up a paper and I'll send you a plaque. You want your name in the Guinness Book of World Records and in the Twin Galaxies International Scoreboard? You have to earn it. I have to earn it. There's a lot of scores I've gotten. And when the time comes and the pressure's that hard, I'll have to do it in a public forum, as I always have. There'll always be the argument that video games are meant to be played for fun. Believe me, some of it's a lot of fun. Video games are meant to be played at home, relaxing, on a couch, amongst friends, and they are, and that's fun. But competitive gaming, when you want to attach your name to a world record, when you want your name written into history, you have to pay the price.